When it was founded in 1914, it was the American Red Cross Volunteer Lifesaving Corps. As far as I know, we are the longest serving, and we are now the only remaining service. There were quite a few other volunteer lifesaving corps around the United States back in the 20s and 30s. The purpose has remained the same, keep people from drowning as best they can. Well, I started in the summer of 1950, and I can tell you the first time I actually had to go in the ocean to get somebody, it was an elderly man, mostly bald-headed, with long hair stringing down in front of his eyes, and he looked more like a sea monster than he did a man drowning. But I did what I had been trained to do. I handed him my buoy. He held on to it very nicely. He didn't try to crawl up on top of me, and I walked him to shore. The uniforms were the biggest change. We wore wool one-piece suits. They did get hot. You're allowed to put the straps down when you're at the station, but when you're out on guard duty or in public, you're standing up in your uniform. It just stayed scratchy and wet. Now we wear basically a rayon or Dacron or some artificial material that doesn't stay wet all day. This was a men's only organization up until 1998. At that time, they admitted two female recruits into the Lifesaving Corps. We use different methods of artificial respiration now than we used back in the day. We have fewer people die from drowning because we have improved methods of artificial respiration. When you get in, usually you're in for 8 to 10 years. When you work together and play together, you get a bond. We still believe in saving lives. I don't know how to describe it more than that. We have a common bond.
Hey, Dateline fans. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking on the button down there and click on any of the videos over here to watch digital exclusives and original content from the creators of Dateline.